We have breaking news out of Watsonville, I should say, where fire crews are battling a very large pallet fire there.
Action News reporter Tom Miller is on scene and has the latest for us tonight. Tom?
Aaron, this building here is Robert Mann Packing, and I'm told that there are pallets and also cardboard boxes that are burning behind me. I want to show you what this looks like. This has actually died down a lot in the last 20 to 15 minutes, but the flames were towering high, well above the power lines, and we're actually told that PG&E is on scene right now. And I'm going to bring in Rosa. Rosa's the public information officer here. And Jimmy, you can just stay on the fire while I talk to Rosa. Rosa, can you tell us, what do you know about how this started? What are we looking at?
So right now, we got the call at 9:57 p.m. this evening, and it came in as baskets on fire. So when the crews got here, of course, it was a big fire, and it's most of the way contained now. They've saved the surrounding exposures, and it's, like you said, it's pallets and just agricultural packaging material. We have 6 engines and 2 trucks here, and we also have AMR and PG&E as well helping out.
And you mentioned there was threat to other buildings. It sounds like there may also be threats to the power lines. What do we know about the power lines overhead?
PG&E just got here a few minutes ago, so we're still getting more information on that.
Okay. And where are we exactly? I know we're one of the cross streets. Is it Riverside Avenue?
We're on Riverside right now, so we're right between Walker and Cicada.
Okay.
So that's the area. So anybody should probably avoid this area because it's all blocked off at this point.
Okay, so it is blocked off. Thank you so much, Rosa. Really appreciate it. As you can see, firefighters are still working out to put out the flames. They're mostly cardboard boxes, like we said before. There are also some wood pallets that are burning. 6 engines are on scene. They have the big ladder trucks. They're spraying down on this fire, and it's definitely going to take a while to put out, as you have those cardboard boxes and the wood pallets just stacked one on top of another. And so while they may have the surface of the fire put out right now, it is just burning deep within the heart of that. Dan, Aaron?
Tom, you know, we've had pallet fires before here on the Central Coast. One comes to mind south of Salinas, what, about 5 or 6 years ago. And those things can burn and burn and burn for quite a while. Can you tell us what they think, and tell us about the fire crews that are out there battling this thing right now?
Yeah, you know, I had a chance to speak with one firefighter, and he was, you know, he actually walked me over to the public information officer, and just what they said is that, you know, it has improved a lot. It's improved a lot recently, but the issue is that because they're so tightly packed, you know, he looked at me and he was like, I said, is this wood pallets? Because when you look at it, you know, you can see that there are wood pallets burning, but he was like, you know, it's wood pallets, but what it also is the cardboard boxes that they have so tightly wrapped up. And you can also see PG&E has just arrived on the scene. You can see they're sort of looking at the wires, those two guys right there trying to figure out what to do. And then, you know, in the background behind them, you have the firefighters with the hoses just sort of spraying into the middle of this, you know, hoping to battle the flames. And now I am starting to see, if you look over at the flames, they're sort of going from left to right. And, you know, that could indicate that there is some wind picking up. This isn't burning straight up into the air. You're seeing that the wind has sort of taken it off to the right, and, you know, over towards where there are more fire trucks, there are more people on scene. We've also been told that Red Cross is just showing up. We know that there were a few homes evacuated. It sounds like there were not any injuries, but certainly people displaced with this dam.
And Tom, that's what I wanted to ask you. It sounds like it's a fairly industrial area, but is there residential areas surrounding it that could be affected by this fire?
Well, Aaron, when we first got the report of this, we were told the average address on the 200 block of Riverside Avenue, and it was just a report of a fire. We didn't know how big it was. You know, there had been a call into the dispatchers, and so I did a quick Google search on Google Maps, and when we got here, you can maybe see just to the right, there's a house, or what looks to be maybe a house or an office on the right-hand side, and the firefighter standing right in front of it. And it's, when I initially had Googled this, it looked like it was a neighborhood, a cul-de-sac with three or four homes around it. And you heard Rosa, the public information officer for Watsonville Fire, say, "We think we've saved all the structures. The structures are not threatened." So while there are people who are evacuated from their homes, and who knows, there could be more damage to these homes, at this point, it doesn't appear that the homes are burning.
All right, Miller reporting for us. Pallet and cardboard on fire there just off Riverside in Watsonville. We'll continue to follow developments and have them for you as they become available.
All right. Thank you, Tom.